Hello everybody and welcome back to the PvPerium channel. Here we are in the wonderful temple of cock blah blah. A place which I think sounds slightly Klingon. So yes, I'm still sitting on this rogue. Ah, beautiful. It took some instant CC there before I'd even done anything. So what we're going to try and do is that I've got some has that man just died? Great. Okay, so I'm going to run off and get the orb, even though right at the beginning of the battleground I said, don't worry everyone, is what we'll do is we'll go and kill the first guy, and then we'll run into the centre, dominate the centre. So I'm glad that I've totally ignored my own request here. I'm taking quite a bit of damage off of this guy. Might want to do something about it? No. Don't bother. Don't want to. No. There we go! This is professional running away, okay? So while I'm half dead, I'll go and pick the orb up, because that seems like an outstanding idea to do. This is the new way that all the high-level players play. They wait until they're nearly dead before they do it. It sort of lulls people into a false sense of security. They think, oh, he'll never pick it up, he's nearly dead. And then I pick it up, and they're like, oh, I did not see that coming. So I've just been blinded there while being attacked. That was, well, that's he's quite clearly been watching the PvP channel there, because that's exactly what I instruct all of you 20k rogues to be doing. Well, this is going swimmingly. I like this an awful lot, actually. What you have on the right-hand side of my screen, which is massively cluttered up, you probably can't make anything of it. There are four names. One of them's YOLO Swagger at the top, covered by a piss-poor interface section thing. And then Nelthar, I don't know who he is. Then Monkey Lover. That's me. And then Vanquish, who I believe was on our team on this one. So we currently have three flags, and they have one. We have a new, on the left-hand side, right over the left-hand side of the screen, sort of just below halfway, we have a new PvP add-on there called PV Penis. PV Penis is dirty, isn't it? So, we're going to try and kill this warrior, who is actually bending me over nicely. I can feel that man in my stomach right now. But he's dead, so, you know. I don't know, maybe the AIDS got him or something. And now we're going to start killing this priest. So, as he is dispersed, I would imagine I probably hit some cooldowns. Just, you know, waste them as per usual. I'm going to switch to the mage. Oh, can't stop, won't stop. I'd love to be able to tell you what that achievement was. Not a clue. So, what's next? Death Knight, let's start giving him some beans. Oh, I'm horrified. I'm horrified. Horrified. He's that ugly. How is that priest to get? I tell you what, we're killing stuff quite quickly here, aren't we? It must be. It's got to be time for a death fet relatively. There it is. Yeah, there it is. So, dead. Isn't that nice? I've died with a healer, though. Looks like we're going to res at the same time. There's our resto druid there. There we go. And off we go. One thing I do like about the rogue is the way that you can just, you don't have any buffs to worry about. You don't fuck about with anybody else. And, oh. Oh, dear. Oh. I would love to tell you what's going on at the moment, but I've quite frankly no idea whatsoever. Right, so let's jump into the centre. That rogue has obviously been a bit of a bellend to me earlier, so I'm thinking, ha-ha, revenge, fuckface! And we're going to kill him. We're going to kill him. Kill him harder. Kill him faster. Kill him more. Yes! So we appear to be dominating the centre of this one quite nicely, actually. Let's go and see if we can put our my little toothbrushes there up his ass. That's what you do as a rogue. That's my theory anyways. You don't bother with daggers. You put a toothbrush in each hand and clean out people's ass. That's it. It's like colonic irrigation. That's not a word. Irrigation, but quite an aggressive form of it. Right, okay. Now we'll move on to the feral druid by the looks of things. And I should probably switch to somebody else at this point. He's not going down. He looks like he's trying to run away. Switch to somebody else. Switch to somebody else. You can switch somebody else. Switch somebody else if you wanted. Hey, that's an idea. Let's switch somebody else. Brilliant. There we go. We switched somebody else. Look. Excellent. So there's a DK in the middle. Oh, no. He's dead as well. My word. We are doing well here. Oh, here we are. Priest. Have it. Take it. He's dispersing again. Let's use some cooldowns. Rogue and a smoke bomb. No! Kill him. Kill him dead. Well, I must say, I think we're doing terribly well here. Where am I going now? Oh, I remember this. The orb on the bottom right, I don't know any of the colours, the blue orb then, went. And I was like, I'll go get it. And I started running top left. Again, what I think you'll find is this is a move which is designed almost purely as bait. You know, they saw me going over them, like, oh my god, that rogue, fuck me, he's been bending us over. There must be something up there. So they then go and follow me around the other side. And I'm not really convincing myself here. Well, so the hunter's dead, there's an orb free. That's something I could go and run for. Stay in the middle, fair enough, why not? Oh, he's come to me with an orb. Disarm me? I was supposed to clean your ass out without a toothbrush. Stupid man. Isn't this fun? There's a lot of them in the center here, aren't there? I get the feeling that we are about, I think I'm about to get filled in a little bit here. Oh dear, you could cloak here. No. I don't appear to be targeting anybody in particular. And that again, you see, I think you'll find is immense skill. Because if you attack everybody once, everyone is scared of you and will then run away from you. It really is, you know, fairly simple psychological warfare. That's the level that we're at now at the Imperium. Down in the pits of about 300 rating. Oh, here we go. So, I made, in all my wisdom, a rule that if it's 20 seconds or more, your res timer, you run back to your corpse. Okay, that's the idea. You just go back to your corpse, and then everybody is like, oh my god, how did he res so quickly? I thought we killed him. Oh my god, these guys are amazing. And, yeah, that works really well. Look, here I am, back again. Ha-ha! But, of course, I'm half dead. So, I have to run away for a bit. Anyway, we'll get stuck in. 3 resto druids on this map is a little bit strange, I have to be honest. Tranquility! Fucker yo! Can't have tranquility. You can't just go be tranquillitying everywhere. Fucking willy-nilly. What's wrong with you, man? Chuck a fucking mushroom down or something. Don't tranquility. Oh, no, it's not looking good for me. I'm going to get killed again, aren't I? Run away, Smash! Run! Ah, shit. Yes. This is where the whole 20-second run back to your corpse thing doesn't really work very well. Well, apparently I've decided to ignore it anyway. But the problem you have is, if you die too often, basically you get back to your corpse and you have a massive res timer. It works the first time. But then it's like, I would leave a minute. Leave a minute, leave 5 minutes, something like that, before you do it again. That's a little piece of pro advice there from old Smashy at the PvPerium channel. I mean, of course, it's been analysed and the numbers have been crunched and the PvPerium engineers are on board with that as well. So, what is even happening here? Where's the fuck is the minimap? There it is. Right, okay, so we appear to have YOLO Swag, Watch Me Grip, and Luno, a wicked Shadow Priest, actually. We met him the other day. Well done, Luno. Thanks for turning up. I would imagine he was horrified at how fucking incompetent we are, even clicking on buttons, but whatever. So, this Resto Druid's going to die. That Resto Druid's in a Cyclone, so we're not going to kill him. What are we going to do now? I'm running for an orb, everyone! I'm going to have an orbgasm! It's mine, I tell you! Hey! Oh, I'm going to pop Cloak against the Resto Druid. Good move. They've been known to one-shot you. Well, I'm Bellend. Right, who's next? What is that there? That's a pet. Kill the pet. Well, this is nice. We seem to have the center all to ourselves. Has nobody got a picnic basket or anything like that? There's a hunter. Hunter. Oh, no. No, there's a half-dead warrior. Go and kill the half-dead warrior. Kill the half-dead warrior. He's dead. And purple's been returned. Oh dear, the horde have got 3 of them. I'm the only one of our team with an orb. Go and kill him. Go and kill him. Go and kill him harder. Toothbrush, toothbrush, toothbrush. McLean's, Colgate. Signal. Those are all toothbrushes where I'm from. That's toothpastes. Maybe I use the toothpaste as lube. Maybe that's like slice and dice or something. I don't really know. Death Nut time. Oh, Death Nut. No, he's not Death Nut. He's Dead Knight. Oh, dear God. Oh, no, I'm dead! Oh, sad face. Oh, here we go. We're off. Ding, Yeah, that didn't really work very well, did it? So, what I'm doing now is, this is some of the level 100 talents I'm trying out already. This is called Haunting. It's where you hang around as a dead man. And you basically scare them. It's an extra fear. Blizzard love CC. This is an instant cast fear. So what they do is they see me and they immediately fear themselves. It's a great little talent, but it does rely on people not knowing what's going on. But yeah, so here we are. 5 seconds until I'm raised from the dead, which that in itself is relatively shocking. And I reckon I'll go and kill a resto druid. Go and kill him! Kill him till he's dead. Doesn't appear to have actually come out of stealth there, so I've done absolutely nothing. Brilliant. Right, Death Knight, Death Knight, Death Knight, Death Knight, Death Knight. Kill him, kill him, kill him faster, kill him harder, kill him more. He's actually going up in health. I might well be healing him. Well, we appear to have won that, and I haven't a single fucking clue what happened. So, that was brilliant. I really enjoyed that. Cheerio, everybody.